star poke. Now palms up. Take the head behind the spine. Arms go up and back towards the launcher. So you're not dripping with yourself because you're in active for extension of the spine. Improving your posture. The opposite posture that your spine is in when you're sitting and Facebooking, right? Not flexion, but extension. Last time, here's your star pose. Now turn the feet to the right side of the pool, towards the shore. Left palm is up, right palm is down. We're gonna go into the water and fake it or really touch the leg as the left hand comes up slightly forward and slowly up. Let's try to do that with dancing with the pranayama or breath. Exhale as you go down and inhale as you come up. Choose. Let's turn the feet in the other direction. Right palm is up. Triangle goes down and comes up right. Little vinyasa of triangle. The purpose is not only stability on a wide base of support, but stretching the right quadratus or stabilizing. Come back here. Feet forward, star pose. Thumbs to the heart. Walk, crawl, or jump your feet to chair. Your right leg is going to lift into stork pose. Regression, touch down. Regression to make it even easier. Bring the right ankle against the left. Or keep it completely by itself against those water currents. Chair pose and stork on the right leg. Shoulders are back. You can always increase the progression by closing your eyes. Making an ocular challenge. Visual affect is always a progression. Chair pose, try to keep the eyes closed. Those 5 minutes are finished. I invite you to open your eyes, open the lips, inhale nose, exhale lips, purse lip breathing. We're going to open and close the dua, open the air, the left. Add a little rotation to the left. Come here and close the door, my friends. And we open the door to the right. And close the door here. Now I'm going to show you a foot pattern. It's called a T-step because your feet look like perpendicular to each other, like the letter T in the English alphabet, and then step out into a line. It's called a bow step, drawing a bow and releasing. Rock back, face the left toes to me, and show me a T-step to the right. And they're not underwear, they're bathing suits. T-step to the right. What's your name? Linda, you should have been in the lecture. Rock back, turn the toes forward, and step into a T-step left. The benefit of wearing white in my body becomes transparent. Right hand on top, you're holding the moon. What are you going to pet? The horse, thank you, both of you remember. And then you're going to pet the horse here, stroke it as you lunge out. Now hold the moon with the left hand on top, rock back. Turn to me, T-step right. Exactly what we're doing on land, my friends, except you're getting 12 times more benefit because you're getting 12 times more surface tension, 12 times more viscosity, and 12 times the resistance of me doing it in the air. Up here. Rock back, turn the left toes to me, embrace the moon, by full moon, T-step to the right, pet the horse's mane to the right. Rock back, hold the moon. Bring your feet together, touch your elbows together, spread them soft, lean it down, open the door, left and right, add a little twist for me. Are your lips open? Is your tongue still where it's supposed to be? Some of you know where it's supposed to be. Oh, Annette, you know. Now let's take the hands out of the water for the first time in Tai Chi. You're getting out of the Chi in front of you and down right into the water. Good. See the Chi. Listen to what it sounds like right now. Oh, it doesn't take a lot. Let's do it two more times. My knees are together. Are you alert? Now we're going to do the reverse. Pull up. One palm on top of the other, doesn't matter which one. Let the water spill. Good, let's do that again. Let it spill. One more time, let it spill and drop and dive into the water. Let it spill. This we're going to call let it spill. Now let's put those together with your lips open. Gather the chi. Bring positive chi into your body and your life. Take something that you don't want out, get rid of it, and release it to the universe. However, it's basically open the door to the left. right hand on top. Move knee here, knee step to the left, and pet the horse's tail. I can see those of you who are getting it versus those of you who started your happy hour early. Head it over here and neck. Face knee, elbows tucked. How are you, GP? Left foot stands in, close the door. Right foot opens up to the right. You're going to learn something new. It's called Lantern of Firefly. Flex the right knee and flex the left knee. But how do you really feel about that? Good. And over the left thigh. Now you're going to stay here and flex the left shoulder so the wrist is just under the surface of the water. Tuck your thumb, that's a tuck with a T. Now carry that lantern across the body and switch. Right hand becomes E. Against my better judgment, I'm going to show you what this looks like from the back. Your left hand is forward and carry the lantern of firefly across the heart and lift up the right hand. The goal is not to come up high, but you stay low. Your chin shouldn't be more than 3 inches from the surface of the water. But not drinking it. Yes, here we go. And switch the arms. Awesome, Sharon. Here we go to the left. We're going to add another move. It's called Rooster Stands on One Leg. As you switch the hands, watch the right knee. Bring it up. Still keep the gloves in the water. Step out right. Carry it across. Pull up that left knee. Rooster stands, or rooster tries to stand on one leg. Left leg goes down. You can reach down. Push it this way, or you can always go down this way. You choose. Here we go across. Left shoulder. Right hand cups the glute. It's yours. Here we go. Carry it across. Hands okay? Good. Did you like that? 5 minutes of that. Now we go to 5 minutes of yoga. So fast, right? You're having fun in Orlando? Try to contain your enthusiasm. Thumbs to the heart, just breathing for the nose. Chair pose, my friend. Do a sun salutation for the water. We'll call it a water salutation. Let's walk, crawl, or jump to star pose. Inhale to a back. Arms go forward. Now let's walk, crawl, or jump to chair. Chair. Remember, the progression of mountain is a back bend. We'll keep the hands in the water just for now. Knees squeezing into each other. Dance, prana. Inhale to an inhalation. To a standing movement. Exhale to an exhalation. To a spread. Now, my friends, we're going to take the right foot from stork, where the right knee comes up, to go to a lunge behind you. The ball of the foot to the bottom of the pool. So it looks like this from side, from here, hinge, and touch. No external rotation today. There's Barbara. Hands are out the side. Now I give you permission to take the thumbs forward out of the water and the rest of the glove in the water. Now back bend. Ears and shoulders behind your hips. I want you to make it sexy. Put the right hip forward. Forget about sexy. Just push the hip forward. Shoulders back. Both particular hands here. Awesome. Feel the chest open and expand while you're pushing the right open, the psoas. Back to stork if you can. Either bring it in a few times or come all the way up to that stork pose. That was the part. Are you cold? Are you okay? This time of the day. That might not be so appropriate for 6 a.m. Squat down. Depends on your temperature. But of course, Linda, the closer you come to me, the warmer it will be. Left knee comes up. Let's hold that stork. Shoulders back and down. The right knee is just soft. Smiling with it. And you're going to take it back to a warrior one. We're going to call it a warrior one lunge today. Thumbs out of the water if you can. Left hip pushes forward. And I invite you to feel how much that left hip opens. We have sitting jaws. And when we do email, it's always in a closed energy position. Now you're getting chi into that space. Open up the heart and try to back bend. We all turn all the same today. She lives. Breathing through the nose. We'll come into stork. Pull up the left knee as much as you're able to. Awesome. Now we're going to do a little faster vinyasa. The right knee comes up. We'll add a posture. Hands go forward as you do warrior one. The right. Now I invite you to place that back right heel on the bottom of the pool. Turn your arms, but keep looking at me, towards the store.
Good.
Palms at the surface of the water. Left palm is down, right palm is down. And now go out of the pool. You go this way, left arm up, right palm.
Touching your leg, a reverse warrior.
Facing the store, come back in. Warrior two, hands at the surface of the water. How cool is this? Because you cannot be out of misalignment. Your hands at the surface without coming out. Whereas on land, people are like this all the time, right?
It's
like
Zumba
arms. Come forward. Stork palms. Externally rotate, that's called a tree. Beautiful. Little mountain chair. If you're not smiling with your mouth, it's okay, but at least smile with your teeth. Lift me up. It's a quotation from Eat, Pray, Love. Hands forward, your right foot goes back down. There's your left. Open and breathe. Hips forward, especially that left. Bring your hands forward. Now you turn towards the hotel, pushing that back left foot on the bottom. Left palm is down, right palm is up, and we reverse that warrior, keeping the right knee over the foot, not in like mine, caves in, and back towards the store. And you can look up at the hand or look forward or just close your eyes. Run. Back to warrior two with your hands in that aligned position, front and back of the walk chair. And you rotate towards me. Now stork is that left knee comes up. Slow breathing through your nose. Here's your tree. Push it out.
Yay!
Spot mode. That finishes in 5 minutes. So it's not moving. Moving now into which is my tongue. Oh, gee, this part is really good. Awesome. Let's open the door to the left. Lips open. I hope you like this song. God, lips are good. Oh, that was in the lecture. But it's not hard, even if you weren't in the lecture. Think about this. The class is called Yo Chi, and if we just finished the Yo, now are we going to do the open the right door. You are the fun side, Linda. You're the live one. There's always one. We now know where she is. Embrace the moon, right hand on top. Here's your T-step left. I'll give it to you from the back. I mean that in the nicest possible way. Pace it over to the left. Now, flying bird. We're going to carry the lantern slowly to the right. Rooster stands on one leg, right here with the drum and the music. Beneath the wall with the right hand. T-step to the right. Embrace the moon. Pet the horse. Hi. Pet the horse's mane to the right. Take the wall without taking your right hand out of the pool. Carry the lantern over to the left side, my friends. And bring that right knee up. Got my surge of inspiration. Right leg goes back out. Carry the lantern, my buddy. Left knee comes up. Left hand is cupping your glute. Are you cupping your glute, Linda? It's your left hand. Switch your hands and you'll be doing exactly what I'm doing. Love you, mean it. Here we go. Cross the body. The right knee comes up. The left hand. Lower your legs, lower your hands. We're going to gather the chi. Arms are going to go out of the water. Nice, slow, and control. Inhale, make that sound. Now we're going to spill. Let's do it two more times with the music. Here we go. And last time, make it dramatic. Beautiful. Left foot steps in, close the door. We're going to learn something new. It's called bow and arrow without legs. Hands to the surface. Draw back your bow. Open it up, Cupid. Bring it back in and go to the right side. Are your lips open? Top to the roof of the mouth. Move back just a little bit, Sandra, so that you are, have the water surface almost at your shoulder. Over to the left shoulder. Right down. Bring it in and sink to the right side. Draw back your bow. It's a great chest active stretch. Now we're going to do it with open door legs. Left foot, open the door to the left. Are your lips open? Yes, Lauren. Arms are up to the left. Now pull up that left knee so it's under the arm, not to knee. That's yoga. Pull it up in the frontal plane. Draw back that bow. Hands at the surface of the water without coming out. Come down. Over to the right side. Which knee comes up now? The store knee. Right. Correct. bow and arrow with legs. The regression is just keep the feet on the bottom of the pool. Right, Ruth? And come back in. And lower down over to the right side. No dairy. Over to the left side. Let's gather the chi. Make the noise. And let us go. Here we go. Now release it. It's an emotional release, in case some of you hear that word release and wonder what I'm talking about. Release up. You still want your pelvic floor relaxed and contracted in the pool. No being in the pool. Bring your feet together. So now it's time for 5 minutes of yoga, right? So we're going to do 5 minutes of yoga and 5 minutes of Tai Chi. I'm going to fuse them together now, okay? Everything we've done so far from the top of mind-body fusion, Captain Kaya Steel, Mento Box, Dim Sum Sampler. Thank you, Francine. Here we go. We're going to start by opening the door. Gather the Chi, my friends.